Allah Rahman Rahim. My name is Zahid Bukhari, and this webinar we are organizing under ICANA Council for Social Justice, and the topic is Making the State of Medina in the 21st Century, Eradicating Poverty and Achieving Shared Prosperity. And we are really fortunate that we have Dr. Fahim Khan. He will be, inshallah, addressing this topic. Dr. Fahim Khan is our friend, our murabbi, our mentor, and he has vast experience in Islamic economics, and he's a well-known Islamic economist. He has studied in Boston University, worked in different universities in Planning Division, Pakistan, Islamic Development Bank in Jeddah. But more than that, not only he has a theoretical knowledge or conceptual knowledge of Islamic economy, He's a wonderful practitioner also. So I will say he's a practitioner intellectual on this subject of Islamic economics. And so inshallah, he will be explaining this model that is a masjid-based model, how to eradicate poverty, how to share prosperity among that communities. And the model could work anywhere, whether it's a Muslim-majority country or where Muslims are living as a minority, like the United States of America and other Western countries. So I will request Dr. Fahim Khan sahab. Inshallah, he will speak on this topic. And then after his presentation, we will also have question and answer. Thank you very much. Yes, Dr. Fahim sahab.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Thank you for allowing me to do this webinar. This is about making the state of Medina in 21st century. There are five different points for its significance, why we should try to do it. First, how to make a community mosque example of state of Medina in 21st century. This is the first step to make for any community share prosperity with the needy people. Our model can be a source of UN World Bank also to learn how to make every country to achieve their 17 sustainable development goals with shared prosperity. This is now a very serious agenda of World Bank and United Nations, and they are pursuing it rigorously with the member countries. And this will be a good source for them, how to advise the countries to achieve these targets. Our model will prove that it is people, not government, who can achieve 17 UN goals with shared prosperity and the World Bank goal of shared prosperity. So the economies are now forced by UN and World Bank to achieve 17 UN sustainable development goals with shared prosperity. Governments do not have resources to do that. They will have to put taxes on people to give resources to government to do which people will not like. And that is not a better and efficient way to do that. Success of this model will also help students, teachers, and planning and policy makers to revise their concept. What is economics and economy in real sense? This is the need of developing countries in general and of Muslim countries in particular. we all may be knowing that billions of dollars are donated every year for humanity in an unplanned charity. There is no shortage of donation and no shortage of charity work. Compassion is an human instinct that exists in every human being. Nobody wants to see poor and poverty around. Only a little part of prosperity needs to be shared by upper 60% to remove them from the poverty trap. Then why hunger and poverty persist all over the world? What is missing? Market is inefficient to earn income efficiently. Why no institution has been developed to share a little more from the income for the needy and for the poor? This is a video that shows how much resources people have to spend on compassionate spending amounts to not only $1 billion but $1 trillion. And where are these $1 trillion going? They are either going to various religious obligations, and most of those religious obligations are for the poor and for the needy. But since it is in unplanned way, and the impact is not seen at national level or at global level. Sharing prosperity is the key economic principle of Islam. Sharing now and sharing for future generation. This is the religious obligation, and this is in the human instinct put by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every human being. We can see it in the Quran in various places. فَأَلَهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. The taqwa part is for humanity. And in Sunnah also, we'll see this principle very clearly, principle of sharing. I will not prove it here. All Muslims know it. And every faith requires it. And humanity requires it. Everyone knows that sharing is necessary. Making someone happy creates my own happiness. I'm happy to make someone happy. This is humanity. This is human instinct. UN and World Bank now require every economy to share prosperity, but it is not happening. The target is 2030. The 17 Sustainable Development Goals, top of which are removing hunger and removing poverty. But now we can see that it is not happening. With the resources that prosperous people are willing to donate, are require very little sharing to end the need of needy. 60% people on the top. If they want to share with 40% people to improve their welfare, the amount they needed is not very significant. These are the statistics that anybody can check. Why this is not happening? there is a river of fire between rich and poor, between the prosperous people and the needy people. Rich are in the trap of prosperity. They are busy in maintaining and sustaining their prosperity that they earn and do not have time to know where are poor and what they need that can get them out of their poverty trap. Poor are in the trap of poverty because they have no easy access to the rich people, and they do not know what exactly are their needs and how to explain their needs to the prosperous people. There is a river of fire between the two, meeting each other may cause burning. A bridge is needed for some helpful people who can cross the fire without burning and make rich people to meet poor people and help them. The problem, why this is not happening. Government, of course, is doing a lot, but poverty incidence is not reduced. People are doing a lot, but poverty is not reduced. Government knows how to do it in planned way, but they have no money. People have money, but do not know how to do it in a planned way. People do not want to give their resources to the government to do their job. There is need to make a system that can make it convenient for people to get poor people to get access to the rest of the people. Solution, we need an institutional setup to let people do it under the government determined plan, but without government intervention in their activities. This is the issue. And what is the river of fire between rich and poor that is not letting them do it is that rich are in the trap of prosperity. They are busy in maintaining, sustaining prosperity. They earn and do not have the time to go nowhere how to find the poor and help them. And same, the poor people are in the prosperity, and that we need a bridge over this river of fire. And what is this river of fire? River of fire is that there is very difficult, even costly, to find who is poor and where he or she is, and what are their needs and how they can get out of poverty trap. That is one part of the fire. It is costly and it may create problems. The other part of the fire is that there is a transaction cost. If rich do find where is poor and what is they needed, this can fire back on them in various forms, which everybody knows that helping someone else may become troublesome also. So there has to be some way where transaction cost does not increase or is not more than the benefits that is being given to the poor. So that is the river of fire. So what we need to overcome this problem? this problem has these five dimensions. A place is needed other than market. Market lets the productive people to produce in best and efficient way. What is the place where rich can meet the poor? Market makes easy for the producers to meet the consumers. What is the place where rich can meet poor? We need an institution to do this. As market is an institution, economics has not been able to define an institution for the people, rich and poor people, to meet effectively and efficiently. We need a volunteering spirit in this. Market provides pricing system, which lets consumers meet producers. In compassion, in helping the people, we need a spirit of compassion. How to meet this compassion? Who are compassionate to meet the poor, and who similarly the poor need that compassion. There is some volunteering spirit, not price, but volunteering spirit to let them meet with each other. How volunteers can bridge this fire or this gap between rich and poor? That is an operational model that is needed, that is required at community level, at government support to make this meeting trustworthy and transparent, and to channelize formal, regular, and informal perpetual financing available in Muslim countries with every human being, but it is not channelized. These are the three things that are required to operate the bridge between rich and poor. And this is required to be achieved in a planned way, in a targeted day and date. And so these are the five elements that we have to discover, and we have to do that if we really want to achieve the UN 17 Sustainable Development Plan goals and World Bank's Shared Prosperity Goal. I have given in red the answer, my answer to what is the place responding to market or complementing market is the community. Community is a place where this should be attempted, effort should be made. What institution is required is the mosque. Community, every community in Muslim countries, community of 200, 300 families has a mosque. There are more mosques than within 200 or 300 families. But we are talking of the mosque where Friday prayer is done. So Friday mosques, which we call Jumma Masjid, they have a community of 200 to 300 families around them. So this is an institution mosque which can utilize the community to make rich with the poor. And how this will be done? We need to have volunteering spirit within the community And Musk knows this. These volunteers exist in Musk, or Musk knows the volunteers in the community. And how to mobilize the volunteers from the mosque? This is the function that mosque can do easily, to make them work willingly within the community, to identify the poor in community and understand their needs, to get them out of poverty trap. This can be done within the mosque and in the community, where there are only 200, 300 families. Operational model will require a law to give responsibility to Waqf department or similar department with IT tools, and this will make easy identifying volunteering spirit, making them volunteers to work, and removing the cost, information cost, and transaction cost through the mosque activities. And if this is done, if these four elements are available, four or six, we need a planned target that this can be done by eliminating the targets of needy that we need. The needy targets are first hunger, then health, and then education of children, and then various other social problems that stop them to get prosper, or stop them to increase their income and welfare. This planned achievement can be done by Waqf Ministry and Planning Ministry in any Muslim country. We have these two ministries. So this is, in fact, this is the model. This is a simple model. And we have tried it. We are trying it in Pakistan. We have identified the mosques with difficulty. And why? What is the difficulty? I can discuss if we have time here. But still, we have found communities and mosques, with a mosque where mosque volunteers are available to work easily, willingly, very willingly. I did not find any problem in finding volunteers in some of the communities that I have identified to work. And the mosque is the issue is that mosque should be willing to do these activities. If these mosque is willing to do this activity, then volunteers are available with true volunteering spirit to bridge to become a bridge between rich and poor. And once these volunteers are available and mosque is organizing them, then sharing prosperity starts. But this sharing prosperity then needs some legal support to motivate the people to do this activity, and to motivate mosque also to do this activity, because it involves financing and fundings. And in order to do it in a planned way, that poverty, hunger, education of children, health of the poor is achieved, this needs a planned target. Depending on the statistics of the prosperity available to be shared, and the needs of the poor to need this sharing. So this is the model, and we are trying it. And what is our objective? We know that sharing prosperity is a natural instinct. Every faith promotes this, so we should not face a problem in starting this project. In Pakistan, everywhere within 200, 300 families and distance, a mosque is available. And volunteers are easy to work with. And the people are available either within the community, otherwise it is easy to find outside the community also. IT technology makes it easy to contact anyone, anywhere to help poor, and people are willing to do this on online also. It is not happening because information cost and transaction cost. That does not let donors to look for needy. And I have explained this those who want to further to know what is information cost and what is transaction cost. And this information cost and transaction cost that makes people now are either in prosperity trap or they are in poverty trap and cannot meet each other. So here is our mission that has three steps. Test the hypothesis that minimizing cost of giving away and receiving donations can let the poor people go to prosperous people in an easy and productive way. If test is positive, then we will look for what systematic environment can minimize this cost and how to create such environment so that it can become easy for donors to donate and easy for needy to receive a productive way so that welfare of poor is improved substantially and poverty is eliminated from the economy at national level and well-off people at every level can fulfill their faith-based obligations at a higher level of piety or taqwa. If we are able to describe how such systematic environment can be created in the economy, then we need to explain governments how to create the proposed systematic environment in the country so that the country becomes free of hunger and poverty and inequality in it grows with sustainable development. So this is the mission to share the prosperity and to make economy develop in a sustainable way, the three steps. And I have discussed these three steps in detail. And those who want to see it, they can see first of our mission, how to test the hypothesis. And our purpose will be following. Select a mosque, focus on the community of around maximum 500, otherwise 200, 300 families is enough to do that. Sit in the mosque to mobilize the spirit of Muwahhad that Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessing upon him, mobilized to identify economic problems at family level and community level and let the wealthy and well-off families to know these problems and mobilize them to help them. Everyone has this spirit. Muwahhad means all human beings are brothers of each other and everyone feels it is natural duty to help any needy from the resources available in hand. The community becomes a family, feeling pains of others as of one's own pains. And this exists in all Muslims everywhere. Spirit of Muwahhad generates a spirit of voluntarily working in this direction. And this removes the information cost and transaction cost faced by donors and needy to meet to let them meet each other. This creates an environment. Voluntary spirit is part of Iman, which requires no return in this world, no reward in this world. As natural instinct, it provides self-satisfaction also, even if no faith is involved. The second part of our mission is understanding how a systematic environment can make this to be achieved. And this systematic environment requires that how mosques can mobilize volunteers to truly identify the needy and to truly identify the donors. And this is what we want to do through mosques. Every mosque normally has a community, a committee. And this committee, if mosque does not have a committee, the mosque can make a committee from within the worshippers who come to the mosque. And this committee then works for the community, because this community of people coming to mosque, they know the families around, who is poor and who is rich and who is willing to donate and who is willing to receive this donation. So this has to be proved. This is the second step. How to create such a systematic environment? It needs to develop institutional framework to work for it and support it. We make a mosque an institution, economic institutions, that creates people to become economically productive and earn income. And we'll use the principle of compassion to prove this second step, creating this institution. Principle of compassion to describe how we can create a systematic environment to make donation easy for donor and needy. And we can use now in the modern time, IT technology makes it very easy. And volunteers and IT then create an environment of trustworthy and transparent. From our model, then we can prove that compassion generates economic activities beyond market. It should be considered as a valid principle for making a beyond market institution. The compassion, a valid principle for making a beyond market institution to complement market in the economy. Until we assign a better name for such a beyond market institution in a community, we can give it any other name, beyond market institution or mask-based institution or whatever, for a policy making in the country, in the entire economy. This will work as a complementary institution with market. And this leads us to the third part of our mission, if we are able to prove this. The third part of institution of mission is to explain to government to make laws to create a legal framework to describe what BMI means or MBI means, etc., and how this can work in the economy to meet the priorities targeted by government in the economy. I will not discuss it here, but only to say that it is difficult to make economic planners something from what they have learned in the name of economics. We need to show them a model that, look, it works. It may not be in economics, it may not be seen in the world, but it does exist potentially, and we have to show it through the model. What we are doing, we are trying to sell our idea, what once was known as the bottle. If we remember that how Coca-Cola was promoted and popularized, it was not in the bottle. And when this demand was going down, the owner was worried about what should do, and his servant told him, bottle it. And when he did it, it got popularized all over the world. So we are trying to bottle our idea in mosque, in the form of mosques. Mosque is the bottle. put the idea in, the, in this water and let everybody know the benefits and the taste and the other benefits. This is what we have to do. For Muslim countries, economists and finance experts need it. It is a business model. It creates prosperity. As we find the ayat in Quran that zakat, this financing, this potential for sharing, rule of sharing prosperity, increases one's own wealth. And this has to be bottled. This has to be shown that this is what will happen if people do this, how the community, everyone will become prosper, not only poor, but the prosperity of prosperous people will also increase. For the world, economists, financial experts, and scholars caring for humanity in World Bank and UNDP, they need to redefine macroeconomic framework to understand how economy works. The way economics is telling them how economy works is not helping any country to find to improve sharing of prosperity. IMF system of macroeconomic framework uses the institution called non-profit institution for serving households, and it has no meanings. It cannot be used by any policymaker. Our institution that we call it mouse-based institution, instead of IMF terminology, this is required to be a part of the macroeconomic framework that IMF requires from every country to prepare. Conclusion, let me finish it here. I want to conclude with this. First, our thinking is not merely for how to make economy to grow with shared prosperity. Purpose of our work is to make a system for economic justice everywhere. Individuals are doing this, what I have described. There is no system that is not letting achieve the target at the economy level that every country wants, and now the world wants, and now IMF wants. It is, in fact, basic and fundamental requirement of social justice. Second, this webinar should not end as the Persian proverb says, Nashistan, the Guftan, the Barkhastan. If our thinking is making sense to the participants and to the ICNA people, then my request is that let it be done not merely to Muslims in ICNA circle, let it be done everywhere in the world. This is thinking, the thinking for the sake of humanity. Let UN and World Bank also know this. UN and World Bank now require every economy to work for humanity. And this is how every economy should work. Economics does not explain it. Humanity is not in economics that we learn in the universities. Economics has to be, has to have a paradigm facing or challenging humanity needs. So that is all with me. I'm free to answer any question or any comment.
Thank you very much, Dr. Fahim. I have, if I can start from the question, then first of all, I think when you are saying mosque-based, so if in a practical shape, who will be the leading this effort, like making mosque-based institution? In the in the community leader, either NGO, mosque imam, mosque leadership, how it will start?
Let me tell you, this is exactly the starting point, the first step. And the first step is to find a mosque where the leader of the mosque, who is khatib, or who is a committee president, or whatever who manages the economy, the activities of Musk. So that is the starting point. We have to convince, we have to sell our idea to them. And unfortunately, in Pakistan, I am not finding this the Musk leaders to be interested in this work. They have their own agenda, the same agenda to serve humanity, but in their own way. This way, if I am trying to convince, and I have been finding a difficulty. However, with the efforts, now I'm getting Musk become interested. The first thing that we started is in textile, a Musk in textile. The people who constructed the mosque, so they have some control on the leadership of a mosque. This effort is going on. One problem that I have found is that mosque again says that the volunteers are very easily available. The problem we find is the committee in the mosque headed by the khatib or the imam, leader imam, that he can motivates in volunteers and also explains this in Friday prayers when every rich and poor in the community comes and they gather here. So these two elements, the mosque plays a major role. Now, how to convince the mosque to take this role? This is a problem, not economic problem. This is a social problem, or this is a political problem. How to make mosque to do this? We have Waqf department in Pakistan all over the world. They can require every mosque. The khatib is their servant, official, government official, 18th grade, 19th grade, 17th grade. And they, government pays for them. Every mosque in the country is under a Waqf department. So they can do, if they are willing, then this starts by making a committee in the community to describe, to find, identify the needs. What are the economic needs? And motivate volunteers. Volunteers that I got in Texila, they are motivated. It was very easy to get the volunteers. The problem was this, they all say that a mosque has to ask them. They have to guide us. We cannot take guidance from outside. This is probably from the mosque or from the volunteers. So finally, in Texila mosque, we agreed that, okay, mosque will do, I have identified 9 aspects, economic aspects in the community to be achieved. And volunteers very voluntarily agreed, yes, we will do it. But they want to do it themselves through the mosque leaders, through the mosque committee or whatever. And I said, okay, this is okay, fine. I will be available whenever they want it. That just keep us guiding, we'll start doing. So this will be, they say it will take time, and I agree that it will take time. But the next mosque I got is a mosque in Hyatabad in Peshawar. This mosque immediately agreed that yes, we can do it. We'll do it as you say and as you say. This mosque is already doing all social activities. The only missing thing is the economic activities to make the people, poor people, to uplift the poor people. That is only missing. And they said, okay, we now know this is missing, and we will willing to do it. And that is how we'll, this type of mosque is needed. The rest of the procedure, I already mentioned the 4 or 5 items, that is easy. The mosque becomes, the leading leader, then everything else is possible. So your question that how it will be done, just making mosque to do it.
Okay. Any other question if somebody would like to ask?
Yes, Jazakallah Khair, Professor Sam, my question is that what do you mean by economic activity, which is missing in that mask?
Yes, very good. The first economic activity is why anybody is sitting idle or sitting poor. IMF statistics, which require every country to find unemployment in Pakistan and in every developing countries, any poor country, unemployment rate is reported as 3%, 4%, 5%, which in the definition of USA and other countries, it is full employment. But on the other side, the statistics show that more than 50% of human resources in working age, 15 years age to 65 years, are not working economically. They are not. They don't want to create income for the family, while the family is poor, is starving. Why this is happening? This is economic activity, that these people who are sitting idle, whether they are women, whether they are children above 15 years of age, if they are not in school, why they are sitting idle? So this is one aspect of economic activity. Find some work. Now, economics defines only wage-paid job. No, they don't want to do wage-paid jobs. But if there is anything, an activity that they can do at home or near home or even outside, away from home, people are willing to do it. Some are willing to do it at home. Some are willing to do it in the street around them. Some are willing to do it anywhere. But they want to do some business type activity, not wage type activity. Wage is a slavery. Economics knows it, that it is a slavery. And the entire population in the country, almost entire, or most of the population is wage slaved. Only few are entrepreneurs who can make the activity, economic activity, and entrepreneurship exists in every human being. Even an illiterate people knows what to do to make some income. But what is missing? This is where the work of government comes, not to create, give money to people, but create opportunities. If government is not doing, people can do it themselves in the community. They can tell the people who are prosperous, they can tell, okay, do you want some training? I will give you training in my own activity. Or if you need some tool or some startup capital, I will give you. The only issue is transparency and trustworthy. And this is what MOSC provides. This is one economic activity. Second economic activity is people, hungry people, they are working. But once they are, if they are sick, they get sick, normal sick, fever or pain or something. One day of loss of work removes their, makes them hungry. The family is hungry. A labor is standing on the road to find anyone to hire them. And whoever comes, they will accept. Whatever way they say, he will accept, he or she will accept, because otherwise the family will starve during the day. So this is removing hunger. Hunger, removing hunger is a responsibility of every person in a community. Surah Maun, what does it say? That even the prayers are not worthy if people do not encourage even feeding the hungry people. So first, the hunger is removed from the community, and to make people work to earn some income, even if it requires for some time to remain without income. The community will take care of their hunger and their food and things. The third, another economic activity is children. Why they are out of school? And this is, we find every an activity, even if it is an activity of rich people, we'll find children begging or going to doing irregular activities. why they are there. Community can solve this. Mosque to mosque and through the help of volunteers and through the help of rich people. And there are other aspects also. And I have described about 9 aspects for our mosque project, which is immediately accepted by the volunteers and by the mosque. Yes, this is what we should do with these 9 activities, economic activities. And let's see how we succeed in this.
One thing, would you be planning to prepare some type of in writing, very very short and comprehensive writing that anybody can learn from, what is the need and the importance and how practically it could be done?
Definitely. I can send you the minutes of the meeting that I do in these 2 committees, the Deskala committee and the Peshawar committee. These minutes are available that explain and what is to be done and how to be done. I can send it to you. To whom? Okay. I will send to Zahir Bukhari.
But one aspect is that that is in the Muslim majority country, I understand, but living in the USA, I was also thinking, how can we make masajid here to think about that? So I thought that there are 3 aspects. It's not a question, but just a little bit explanation. One is that one masjid in one town or in a major metropolitan city in one area, they can think about their prosperous people, community member, and needy community member. And they can think about these innovative style that how to support them. That's a need more discussion. Second aspect could be here, the U.S. Council of Muslim Organization is the umbrella group of American Muslim Organization. They like to start a twin mosque program initiative, where the metro, the urban suburban masajid or immigrant masajid, they will work with the inner city Afro-American local Muslim masajid, and if they work together, they can very easily think about working on this model. That normally the idea is that immigrants community, their masajid are more prosperous, and our local community, they have less economic activity. They can think about how to make this shared prosperity with these 2 masajid. And the third aspect could be that in small town and any town, if masajid can work with other faith-based groups like churches and synagogue or other groups, and they can think about that in their town, how they can have this shared prosperity model workable. So this, I think we can also think about, but probably we will be waiting for, we'll be looking for some more detailed practical model working over there. And then I think we will try to have some thinking process going on here, but that will be more helpful, inshallah ta'ala.
Definitely, you're right. And you answered all your questions. So the only thing you want is a model. Show it how it works. And this is not you. Everyone whom I'm telling, the government and the World Bank and the IMF, show us how it can be done. Show me where it has been done before. So this is the only issue that I'm facing. And that is what I'm trying to prove, inshallah. So as you said, keep you informed how it is working. And inshallah, you will get it. This Peshawar model is very quick in doing it. And I met only 2 days ago, and they are very keen that even if you're on Ramadan, please come and guide us how to do it.
Okay, my question is particularly about your bottle idea. How, what do you have in your mind about the sustainability? How they will sustain this thing in the community? Great. They will keep on doing it?
Right question. And the question is related to funding, the financing. In every community, finance will be managed? How will provide, how the funding, from where will the funding come, who will manage it, and how it will be sustainable, that it is not done once and sustainability keeps coming. This is in the basic point, that the mosque committee in the mosque will manage the financing. The only thing that is required is government support, because government doesn't allow private institutions to collect money. And this is what is required from the government. And once it is available, as I mentioned, the resources are not short. 60% population has to uplift the 40% people in the bottom. And not much is needed. The only this is in the instant. Everyone wants to do it. The only problem is that there is a system, transparent and trustworthy system, that their money is not wasted and not used illegally. This is the basic in the model. This is the model I have mentioned, that there are three types of funding that are created daily, spent daily. Informally, in the mosque to the beggars, in the market to the beggars, in the neighborhood, in the poor, and informally giving some money. This should be channelized. There is a regular spending in the form of zakat and usher. This is not being truly planned. Governments are trying to do it in Pakistan, in Brunei type rich countries, in Pakistan type poor countries. A lot of zakat is available potentially, but is not being used. So, and this is the part of the system. When I prepare a law on the basis of this model, then this will be the basic thing to get it implemented through Waqf Department and through the law department. So there will be three institutions involved: law department, Waqf Department, and planning department, to make this model sustainable. There is a COPS, an institution of Waqf also. People give land and other properties, and even cash now can be made Waqf. So how to make it a part of this model, to make it sustainable. So sustainability is on finance, not on voluntarily. So finance, if finance is made sustainable by the law, then the resources are available. They are much more than need require, very little, 3%, 4%. And this even only zakat can meet, but people are spending much more than zakat, potentially they have. They want to do more, but the system is not there. So the system is the key for sustainability. Thank you. Good question.
Okay, thank you. And answer is also very logical. Thank you so much.
Thank you. So one more question. What about, if any, advice that major international relief organizations, they are working in like in the West, but they are working in the Muslim third world countries, or in other countries like Pakistan, Turkey, there are huge, big relief organizations. How can they adopt that model? Is there any discussion on that they work to create that model in a village or in a town or in a small area of a major city?
You are talking of these NGOs and...
major NGOs. Can they be helpful in this creating or formatting of this model?
Yes, and include in this question mosque also. Mosque, NGOs, and charity organizations. Why they are not able to eliminate hunger and poverty from the entire country? Why? This question you can also mention. I also mention their agenda is different. How to make them... this agenda. They have their own agenda. Everywhere, this organization, whether NGO or charity organization or mosque, they have their own agenda. How to convince them that make your agenda also within this? Who will do it? This is, I said, the political thing. This is politics. So this is what is not letting me convince the mosques. Only a few, and a couple of mosques. And I have another suggestion from two other mosques. So there is willingness, but how to motivate? them. This is the issue. How to can make this their agenda?
Okay. Okay. Is there any other question? Otherwise, we are really thankful. Thank you very much, Dr. Feinsaub, and whoever is watching and listening, and hopefully learning from this webinar. Thank you very, very much from ICNA, Council for Social Justice.